Hello all, welcome to this video on linear algebra. Today we'll be seeing how to solve a system of linear equations using row echelon form. System of linear equations play a central part in linear algebra. Many problems can be formulated as systems of linear equations, and linear algebra give us tools for solving them. The general form of a system of linear equations is as given here. Here x1, x2, etc., xn are the unknowns of the system. Every n tuple, which includes x1 to xn, that satisfy these set of equations is a solution of the linear equation system. If we consider a system of linear equations as here, and use the rules of matrix multiplication on it, we can write it into a more compact form, which looks like this. Note that here x1 will scale the first column, x2 the second, and x3 the last. Generally, a system of linear equations can be compactly represented in their matrix form as Ax equal to b, and the product Ax is a linear combination of columns of A. That is, the first matrix include the coefficient of all the x terms. The second vector consists of the x terms x1, x2 and x3. And the last vector consists of the constants in the equation. The general approach we usually follow for solving a system of linear equations consists of three steps. First, we find a particular solution to Ax equal to b. Then we find all solutions to Ax equal to 0. Later, we combine the solutions from step 1 and 2 to give the general solution. Note that neither the general nor the particular solution is unique here. There exists an algorithmic way of transforming any system of linear equation into a simple form, which is called Gaussian elimination. The key to Gaussian elimination are the elementary transformations of systems of linear equations, which transform the equation into its simple form. Now we will see how these elementary transformations are done. The key to solving a system of linear equations are the elementary transformations that keep the solution set the same but transform the equation into a simple form. This can be done in three ways, either by the exchange of two equations or rows in the matrix representing the system of equations, or by the multiplication of an equation or a row with a constant, or by the addition of two equations or rows. Next, we'll see what a pivot is. The leading coefficient of a row or pivot is the first non-zero number from the left. It should always strictly be to the right of the pivot of the row above it. Any equation system in row echelon form always have a staircase structure. Here the word echelon means a staircase. In the example given here, the pivot elements are in the columns x1, x3 and x4. In case of column x2, the digit -2 comes in the same level as the pivot element of column x1. Also in the case of x5, the digit -2 comes in the same level as the pivot element of x4. Now, as the case of basic and free variables, the variables corresponding to the pivots in a row echelon form are called the basic variables. In our example, these are x1, x3 and x4. All the other variables are the free variables. Here they are x2 and x5. Now we'll see what row echelon form is. A matrix is said to be in row echelon form if all the rows that contain only zeros are at the bottom of the matrix. Correspondingly, all the rows that contain at least one non-zero element are on top of the rows that contain only zeros. Now, looking at the non-zero rows, the first non-zero number from the left, also called the pivot or leading coefficient, is always strictly to the right of the pivot of the row above it. Now we will see how to solve the following system of linear equations using the elementary transformations in row echelon form. We'll start by converting the system of equations into a compact matrix notation, which is Ax equal to B. We'll no longer mention the variables x explicitly and build an augmented matrix, which is of the form A slash B, where we use the vertical line to separate the left-hand side from the right-hand side. So we'll obtain a matrix A slash B like this from the set of equations we were given. Now I will apply elementary transformation to the given matrix here. So first of all, I will swap the rows R1 and R3, which gives me a resultant matrix like this. Now I found that if I add R2 with minus 4 times of R1, I will get zeros in the second row. So I'll convert the second row as R2 minus 4R1. This will be the resultant matrix. Similarly, I will add the third row with 2 times the first row, which will again give me zeros in the third row. This will be the result. Also, I'll subtract the fourth row from the first row, which will give me zeros in the last row. This will be the resultant matrix. Now I'll try to make all the elements in the last row as zero. I found that when I subtract R4 from R2 and R3, I'll get the last row as zero. Now I'll do the transformation R4, giving R4 minus R2 minus R3. This will be the result. Now when I examine the third row, I see that all the elements are multiples of 3. And since I have to change the sign for convenience, I'll multiply it by minus 1 by 3. Also, I'll multiply the second row with a negative sign to make it positive. So I'll transform R2 as minus R2. This will be the final matrix. And this form is the row echelon form. Now I will convert this matrix back into the equation form, such as x1 minus 2x2 plus x3 minus x4 plus x5 equal to 0, x3 minus x4 plus 3x5 equal to minus 2, x4 minus 2x5 equal to 1, and 0 equal to a plus 1. Now we see that if we replace the value of a with minus 1, then only we'll obtain a solution for this set of linear equations. So I substitute a with minus 1, so this equation becomes 0. Now we need to find the particular solution. So for that, we will set the non-pivot columns to 0. Non-pivot or the free columns we saw before to 0. So in this example, the pivot elements are in the columns x1, x3 and x4. Thus, the free variables or free columns will be x2 and x5. I will set them both to 0 and substitute them in these equations to get the result for the particular solution. So when I substitute 0 for x5, I get x4 equal to 1, x3 equal to minus 1 and x1 equal to 2. From that, I will derive the particular solution vector as 2, 0, minus 1, 1, 0. Next, we will find all the solutions to Ax equal to 0. For this, we will be using the null space concept, where null space is used to capture all the possible linear combinations of elements that will produce 0. So, in this method, we will find the free variables and substitute them with convenient values in order to get the solutions for Ax equal to 0. The free variables here are x2 and x5. Since a null matrix is represented in terms of an identity matrix whose elements are 1s and 0s, I will substitute x2 and x5 with 1 and 0 for two set of special equations. So one case will be where x2 is 1 and x5 is 0. For the second case, it will be x2 0 and x5 is 1. As in the first case, when x2 is 1 and x5 is 0, I'll get the values of x4 as 0, x3 as 0 and x1 as 2. Note that these equations are the same as the equations from the row echelon form. It's just that I have replaced the right hand side with 0 because we are trying to find out the value for Ax equal to 0. Now when x2 is 0 and x5 is 1, I'll get the results as x4 equal to 2, x3 is equal to minus 1 and x1 as 2. From these two, I'll get two vectors. The first vector when x2 is 1 and x5 is 0 is 2, 1, 0, 0, 0. So any multiple of this vector will also be a solution to Ax equal to 0. So I'll multiply it with a scalar lambda 1. Similarly, the vector I obtained when I substituted x2 equal to 0 and x5 equal to 1 is 2, 0, minus 1, 2, 1. Since all its multiples will also be a solution to Ax equal to 0, I'll multiply it with a scalar lambda 2. So my set of all possible solution or the general solution will be a combination of my particular solution and solutions to Ax equal to 0. This will be represented as x element of r raised to 5, because we have 5 x terms, which will be equal to, that is x is equal to the particular solution, which is the vector 2, 0, minus 1, 1, 0. Here the plus sign is used to show that it is a combination of these two solutions. Lambda 1, the second vector 2, 1, 0, 0, 0 plus the third vector multiplied by lambda 2, 2, 0, minus 1, 2, 1. Here lambda 1 and lambda 2 are real numbers. So this will give us the general solution of the given set of linear equations. That's all for now. Thank you for watching.